Warplanner is the custom-built platform for online play of GMT's World War II strategy game, A World at War. This video will explain how to use Warplanner so you can play anyone, anytime, anywhere. If you want to see more videos on A World at War, show your support by subscribing. Warplanner is web-based, so it can be used on personal computers, Macs, iPads, iPhones, and anything else that can access the internet. To use Warplanner, you have to create an account by going to the Warplanner website as shown. When you do, you will see the login box in the upper left corner of the screen. When you click on Register, this takes you to a second box where you enter your first and last names, your email address, and a password. Warplanner will then warmly welcome you and will send you an email so you can complete your registration. When you get the email, just click on Complete Registration to complete your registration. This confirms that you aren't a World in Flames bot in the Urals. To start a new game, you click on New Game. So far, a lot of Warplanner seems to be pretty straightforward. To illustrate Warplanner's functions, we will set up a classic game starting in Fall 1939. As you can see, the units are not only sorted, but already set up, although of course the players can change the initial position of the units if they want to. To move around on the map board, just left-click on it and drag it, or scroll using a mouse. This lets you go to any part of the map board almost instantly. There are two ways to get a closer look at the map board. The first way is to press the Control key and scroll. This is quick and easy, but the image will get a bit blurred. The second way is to click on the plus button in the bottom right of the screen. This redraws the image on the screen. Clicking on the minus button in the bottom right of the screen has the opposite effect. The Warplanner command menu is found on the left side of the screen. Here's a closer look at it, split into two columns. When you click on the New Game icon, the New Game box appears. We have already seen how this works. If you accidentally click on the New Game icon, you can go back to an existing game by clicking on a game listed in the left column of the New Game box. The Save Game command allows you to save the current position in your game. If you want to download the file for the position, click on Download. If you want to add a player, click on Edit Players and add the email address of the new player. When you save, you can type in a comment, which causes Warplanner to notify all the players in the game by email that the position has been saved. If you save without a comment, no one else is notified, but whatever you've done since the last save is safe. The Switch Theater command does exactly that. It sends you from Europe to the Pacific, or vice versa. The die roll command is used to make die rolls. The box that appears when you click on the die roll command has a number of features. The first line in the die roll box is the title, which defaults to the sequence of play status at that point in the turn. The title can be changed manually if desired. The sides die defaults to 6 for A World at War, but can be changed for other games. In other words, this die roller can be used for Gathering Storm and Storm Over Asia. The Rolls line box is the number of dice rolled. For example, 1 for ground attacks and attritions, 2 for air combat and strategic warfare, 3 for research, and so on. The lines box indicates the number of die rolls to be made. If you had 3 ground attacks, you would set this at 3. The total is just the number of dice per roll times the number of rolls. The details box is then completed in however much detail the players wish. For example, for ground attacks, the moving player might list not only the attacked hexes, but also the attacking units, the defending units, and the odds. Once everything is in place, you hold your breath and click the roll button. The results will be displayed in the results section of the die roll box. Clicking on the force spool icon calls up the force spool box, which gives you a selection of force spools. The major power force spools are listed at the left, but the menu also contains minor country forces. For example, calling up the German force spool shows you the unbuilt German units. Clicking on the shipboard icon calls up whichever shipyard is selected. Clicking on the code-breaking icon allows players to secretly draw the code-breaking cards for their side. When you click on the task force command, you can see the task forces for each of your side's major powers. The task force box is password protected, so you can't see what's in your opponent's task forces. When you click on the attrition command, the attrition box appears. This lets you calculate your attrition levels simply by selecting the units that will attrition. Warplanner does the math. The diplomacy command opens the diplomatic box. It's important to realize that diplomacy is done outside of Warplanner. The purpose of the diplomatic box is to allow the players to inform Warplanner of any diplomatic results. New units are created using the new units box. This is a very powerful tool, which allows any type of unit to be created for any country. The new unit function is essential for a World at War games that arise out of Gathering Storm and Storm Over Asia, where force pools vary from classic A World at War. The Ships at Sea box shows the active naval units for the selected major power. This is a useful function to check on things like the number of Western Allied destroyers or carriers. Ships may be shown stacked by type, or each ship may be displayed separately. For major powers that may have ships in both theaters, you can view all their ships, just the ones in Europe, or just the ones in the Pacific. Finally, just for fun, Warplanner lets you see what ships have been sunk for each major power. The keyboard shortcuts box lists the various shortcuts that can be used as commands. These are very useful, and players will become more familiar with them as they play. We will use some of them when we go through the Axis Fall 1939 turn. Let's look at a few of the most important ones now. To break down a factored unit, such as an army air unit, left-click on the unit, then type a number. To combine several smaller units, left-click on the top unit in the hex, and type C. When a unit is lost in combat, or for some other reason, there are two ways to handle the situation. The first is to left-click on the unit, then type E. This marks the unit as eliminated, and it will be returned to its force pool when the moving player reaches the unit construction phase in the sequence of play. The second is to left-click on the unit and type F. This immediately returns the unit to its force pool. But don't left-click on the unit and press the delete key, as this permanently eliminates the unit. A prompt will ask you for confirmation that that is what you really want to do. To check on hex control, type C without left-clicking on a unit. The units will disappear and every hex will have a flag in it. To return the board to its normal state, press the escape key. To put colored dots on the map board, which can be very useful both when planning and executing a move, type M, again without left-clicking on a unit. The color that will appear will be shown in the upper right corner of the screen. If you keep typing M, various other color options will appear. When you have the color you like, just left-click on a hex. To get rid of a dot, left-click on the hex containing the dot. To get out of this function altogether, use the escape key. Over the years, conventions have evolved as to how to stack units. Air units are normally at the top of a stack, then armor units, then infantry units, then other counters. In this starting position, the Germans have gotten everything wrong. This can all be resolved just by typing O, which corrects every stack of units with a single command. The final command is for settings. When this is opened, the players can customize the appearance of the counters and map board in various ways.
Outside the barracks, by the corner light, I'll always stand and wait for you at night. We will create a world for two. I'll wait for you the whole night through. For you, Lily Marlene. For you, Lily